Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can print these two different patterns in C programming. Before starting, you can note my information. You can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the link youtube.com/SanjayGupta_TechSchool. You can download my Android app, that is TechImage, which is available on Google Play. Now coming on to the topic, first I am going to demonstrate you how you can print this pattern. So we are going to analyze this. Here you can see I am placing hyphen in place of space so that you can understand how much space is required before printing the letter. So if we write down the analysis, in first row total 4 number of spaces and 1 letter is required, then in second row 3 spaces and 2 letters, in third row 2 spaces, 3 letters, then 1 space, 4 letters, then 0 space and 5 letters. This way we need 2 loops, one for printing spaces and one for printing letters. So spaces loop will be controlled by this n minus I, and letters loop will be controlled by I. N is representing number of rows and I is representing the current row. So suppose initial value of I is 1 and n is 5, so n will be 5 always, and first time I will be 1, so 5 minus 1 will be 4, so 4 spaces will be printed. Second time I will be incremented by 1, so to print second row value of I will be 2, so 5 minus 2 will be 3. So this way, using this notation n minus I, we can find out these number of spaces for a particular row. Similarly, with the help of I, because I is representing a particular row, we can find out how many letters will be displayed in a particular row. So if I is 1, so 1 letter. If I is 2, then 2 letters. If I is 3, then 3 letters, and so on. So total 3 loops are required, one for printing space, one for printing letters, and one for representing rows. Here you can see through printf scanf I am reading number of rows, then I loop is repeating n times. So I loop is responsible for providing row number through I variable. Then ch is initialized with a. Then second loop, here you can see the condition which I have demonstrated you earlier, n minus I. So n is total number of rows and I is representing current row. So first time current row is 1, so value of I is 1. So 5 minus 1 is 4. This loop will repeat 4 times and it will print spaces. After printing 4 spaces, second loop, that is k, is available, which is repeating i times, and it will print letters through ch. And after printing a letter, ch is incremented by 1, because in second row just after a we have to print b, so b will be printed by this ch plus plus. After completion of k, new line will be displayed using slash n. This way, through this a combination of nested loop, pattern will be displayed on console. So I am executing this code. It is asking for number of rows. You can see the output and you can compare it with this output. Both are same. Now we have to display this reverse pattern. So for this purpose, you just have to change in first loop only. You have to initialize it with I equals to n. Its condition will be I greater than equals to 1. And it will be decreased by 1 every time. Now again I am executing this code. You can see the output. It is printing the same pattern which is required here. So friends, while I is starting from n, so suppose n is 5, then this j loop, which is printing 0 space first time, because n is 5 and n is also 5. So 5 minus 5 is 0, that's why this loop will not repeat, but k loop will repeat 5 times because value of I is 5. So 5 letters will be displayed on console, that are A, B, C, D, E. Then new line will be displayed, then I will be decremented by 1, so it will become 4. Then when control will be available on J loop, so n is 5 and I is 4, so 1 will be available here. So one space will be displayed with J loop. Here K loop will be repeating 4 times because I is 4 this time. So 4 letters will be displayed. So after one space, 4 letters will be displayed. And this way, all the pattern in reverse order will be displayed on console. So I hope you have understood how we can print both the patterns with the help of nested loop in C programming. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow my YouTube channel through the link youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. Thank you for watching this video.